Good morning. I would like to come and participate in your seminar, but it's a pity today I have a conference in the European Parliament, so I wish you good success. Indeed, citizen participation in renewable projects should be an explicit political choice. The Greek government, under the pressure of the Troika, is unfortunately moving towards the opposite direction. I believe that social economy structures in general will be explicitly supported by the government in order to send to the society a clear message that this choice exists and it can truly help in these times we live in. As far as energy projects in particular are concerned, I think one needs to address the heart of the problem, which is renewable energy sources development in general, with or without the operative model. In my country, Greece, citizen participation in renewable energy sources projects is hindered by citizens' overall skepticism towards renewable energy sources. People are misinformed, and renewable energy companies typically promote huge projects which are clearly beyond the current capacity of the place where the project will be developed. From the other side, the state frequently fails to ensure that the environmental impact is minimized. Moreover, due to the crisis, there have been successive and violent changes of to the feed-in tariff system, which has dramatically undermined the trust and stability which are necessary to develop RES projects. These obstacles can be overcome through establishing a constant feed system which will be agreed upon by all stakeholders and the Troika. Better and more responsible information offered by the state to the citizens on the significance and the merits of RES development. Also, by establishing a higher fit for social cooperative enterprises and for regions disengaging from lignite mining. In the first case, the acceptance of the renewable energy will be increased and the economic benefits to local communities will be maximized, while in the second case it will boost a faster transition to the post-lignite era. RESCOOP can play an instrumental role in aiding RES development via the cooperative model by providing the know-how to energy cooperative efforts in countries like Greece and by showing, through existing examples in Europe, what is possible in terms of reducing energy consumption, using clear energy, and of course maximizing the financial benefits for the local community, something that is very interesting and important at this era. I think that the most important obstacle at the European level is not related to the cooperative model. It is the recent ambivalence of the commitment towards RES and climate change policies and goals. The recent result of the vote on the backloading issue was disheartening, but even the vote on the future of RES, Reul report, although it included a commitment on a goal for RES participation in the mixture of 2030, it marginally and failed to be specific on the level of RES participation. Moreover, the huge pressure that is exerted to develop shale gas resources and the looseness of the recent Javella report of the Energy Roadmap 2050, which is open to all technologies, give a complete picture of the current gloomy situation regarding energy policy and goals at the European level. Thus, I believe that a firmer and clearer commitment towards RES development is a prerequisite for the blossoming of the cooperative model, which by constructions, by its first idea, is best suited for dealing with the unprecedented economic crisis we are facing now.